It's another week, another edition of Film Room here from the Star in Frisco alongside former Cowboy Isaiah Stanback. I'm Kyle Yeomans as we look ahead now to the Minnesota Vikings in, well, week number 8. After a week off, the bye week is in the rearview mirror. The Cowboys are getting ready to take on a tough challenge in this Minnesota Vikings team. And let's start on the defensive side, where really the Vikings' strength is their front seven. They're going to get after Ezekiel Elliott on a couple of occasions.
Absolutely. When you hear Minnesota Vikings, you think about their defensive coordinator, Mike Zimmer, his ability to bring pressure. But he doesn't always have to bring pressure because of how dominant he's been up front with his front seven. There are two dudes that you need to be aware of. This guy right here in the name of Barr, and then you got this dude right here by the name of Kendricks. Both of these guys are absolute complete dogs. Oh, and by the way, Kyle, I'm sorry. There's another guy that they have, a pro bowler by the name of Harrison Smith right here. He is really, really good, and he likes to come down from the free safety, from a strong safety position. There's a couple guys that we had on our team previously, too. Everson Griffin right here, and we also have Xavier Woods. These guys like to bring pressure. These guys want to bring a pressure and establish a line of scrimmage up front. As you see here, these guys are getting back in the backfield. Take a look at here. This was the original line of scrimmage, okay? This is the original line of scrimmage. Look how far back these offensive linemen get pushed back. These guys are 2 yards in the backfield, 2 yards in the backfield. Run it back for me just a little bit. Okay, right here on this 35-yard line, look where their linebackers are creating contact. Boom, at the line of scrimmage. Boom, at the line of scrimmage. You got Harrison Smith coming up and applying pressure on the tight end as well. And then look what they end up doing to this running back back here of Hubbard. They do not allow him to barely get back to the line of scrimmage. You get like a 1 yard gain. These guys like to bring pressure up front. We're gonna have to do a great job of being nice and stout and pushing these guys back. Otherwise, they're gonna create problems for us in this backfield.
And there's so many good players at that second level. You mentioned Barr, you mentioned Kendricks. I mean, those are guys that both of them are gonna have a lot of success if they're able to scrape off of their blockers on the second level. Now, when we move on to this next play, it goes to the offensive side of the football, and this is Dalvin Cook. Yeah. Having to slow down Dalvin Cook is gonna have to be a tough task for really the second level of the Cowboys defense.
Yeah, Dalvin Cook is a problem, right? He's one of the best that the league has to offer. But even more so, they're doing a great job with Kubiak being their offensive coordinator. They're doing a great job with this zone running scheme. Much like their defensive line, their offensive line is really the foundation of this team here. And as you see here, these guys do an amazing job, okay? So we got Cook back here in the backfield. All right, he does a great job. But watch this offensive line. I want you guys to watch how these guys reach. They get double teams, okay? They wall off this thing, and they are literally going to create a nice little ravine for this guy to run through. Let's take a look here so you guys can see what I'm talking about. Boom, pause it right there, right there. Look what this offensive line has done. They have literally shielded off the defensive end because he decided to dip his head on the inside. These guys are working up, to shielding off this offensive line as well, the defensive line. And then these linebackers, look what the linebackers' eyes are. These guys are in the backfield, but they're in the wrong side. He's keeping his eyes on Kirk Cousins on the bootleg, which allows the offensive line to literally wall off this right here. These guys are getting a kick out block. So you literally have this entire way right here with Cook, he can see everything work his way all the way up to the next level. And then you have Thielen and Jefferson doing a great job working to the second level, getting their blocks. And if you're going to come up from the safety position and try to tackle this man, Dalvin Cook, you better bring your A game, as you guys see right here. Look how he takes on this block. Oh my goodness. Yuck. You better bring your hard hat because that dude is coming downhill fast.
Yeah, he is so tough to take down on first contact, and that shows the importance of setting the edge from the edge rusher spot and then also scraping off and keeping your eyes at least disciplined in the backfield. You cannot be tricked by the multiple ways that Minnesota can beat you. Speaking of multiple ways, how about these wide receivers?
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, so these guys have two of the best route runners in the league, okay? These guys are very, very sneaky. Not only do they have Dalvin Cook, who can catch the ball at the backfield, not only do they have Kirk Cousins, who can deliver the ball with his 13 touchdowns and only 2 interceptions this year, but they have a dude by the name of Thielen, okay? And Thielen is right here, all right? Thielen's going to run a nice little in route on the backside, okay? And then versus single high, which is what we like to play. We like to play single high because you have to respect the run, all right? You want to make sure that you have a full box to handle Dalvin Cook, but if you go single high, then there's a dude by the name of Jefferson. And this guy, Jefferson, is going to take you all the way up. He's going to stick you like he's going to run a corner route, and he's going to cross this face. And who is back here to cover? Absolutely nobody. This cornerback ends up coming up here, all right, and biting on the Thielen route. Let's see this thing play out. All right, so boom, you see it here, ball snap, play action, pause it right there. Look where these linebackers are right off the bat. Linebackers are here, they have the eyes in the backfield. Now he's running out trying to get underneath the routes. He's trying to create pressure on Kirk Cousins. Look at this middle of this field. Middle of the field is wide open for Thielen to work. I don't care who you put on him, he has the whole middle of the field to work. That's hard to defend. Look at Jefferson. He is running the post corner route, right, but he's really taking it to a post. Where's his safety going? This safety is like, ooh, there's nobody over there. I have to get there. Where is their third receiver? Okay, the rookie. All right, he is right here. All right, he's doing a good job of sitting there and trying to pull this cornerback to free up this corner, which makes him think I have to get there. And then right here, Kirk Cousins, even though he's completing 69.5% of his passes, he is still missing on big plays. Let's hope that he continues to miss against the Cowboys this week.
Man, they had all three guys wide open. Yep. KJ Osborne, look at Justin Jefferson, Adam Thielen. That's how this Minnesota team can beat the Cowboys. Hopefully, the Cowboys can come up with a good scheme. Dan Quinn's done it so far this year. They've been forcing takeaways, susceptible to the big play. It's going to be a little bit of a give and take again this Sunday. He's Isaiah Stanback. I'm Kyle Yeomans. That does it for us here on Film Room.